Hello everyone, in this lecture we will discuss partially ordered set. So as you have already defined a partial order relation, so here look at this again. A relation R on P is called a partial order relation if it is reflexive. It means for all x belongs to P, x, this ordered pair must belongs to R. Similarly, antisymmetric, you can say for all x, y belongs to P, if x, y, this belongs to R, and y, x, this belongs to R, then this shows or this implies x equal to y. So this is antisymmetric relation. Similarly, transitive, you can write for all x, y, z belongs to P, x, y belongs to R, and y, z belongs to R, then this implies or tautologically implies x, z belongs to R. So if a relation R on P satisfies these three conditions, reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive, then we will say it is a partial order relation. And a set P with this partial order relation is known as a poset. Poset means a set together with a partial order relation. Now we'll utilize the symbol. This is not less than or any other symbol. Simply we'll utilize this symbol. You can use any other symbol. We will use this symbol to denote a partial order relation. Means whenever we are writing this symbol, this denotes it is a partial order relation. So suppose P is a set and a partial order relation is defined in this way, then we can denote a poset with this one. Means there is a set and with the partial order relation, this one. This relation may be any kind of relation. For example, if you look at the partial order relation, which is reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive. Say for example, less than or equal to. So less than or equal to, you know, this is reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive also. So this relation may be equal to less than or equal to. So we can represent this as less than equal to when we define this. But until unless we define, we simply use this as a symbol for partial order relation. Now some examples. Which of the following sets are posets? Look at this. This is set of integers and the relation, partial order relation defined as greater than equal to. Now you know this greater than equal to is reflexive because for all x you can write x is greater than equal to x. Similarly, so it means this is reflexive. For antisymmetric, if you write x greater than equal to y and y greater than equal to x, then you can write x equal to y. So it means this is antisymmetric. And for transitive, you can write if x greater than equal to y and y greater than equal to z, then you can write x greater than equal to z. So this satisfies all these three conditions. Therefore, it is a poset. Now look at this. Z divides. Divides, note the relation. This is a divide. The relation divides. And defined on set of integers. So look at this. For all x, you can write x divides x. It means this is reflexive. But if you look at this, if you take two different elements, minus x and suppose say x, because it is a set of integers, so we can take minus negative integers also. So if you take two different, minus x and x, so we can write minus x divides x and x divide minus x, but x is not equal to minus x. So it means this relation is not antisymmetric relation. Therefore, this is not a poset. But if you define this relation in a set of positive integers z plus, then it may be a poset. But here, this is defined the set of integers z and we can take negative integers and this is not antisymmetric. Similarly, if you see this, P is a collection of sets and the relation is contained. You know, this relation of this subset is a partial order relation because for every set x you can write is a subset of itself. You know, for two sets, if x is a subset of y and y is a subset of x, then we can write x equal to y. And you know, when x is a subset of y and y is a subset of z, then you can write x is a subset of z. It means this is reflexive and symmetric and transitive. So this is also a coset.